Kendrick Lamar is finally back with a new album, and he confirms this will be his last album with TDE. And this is massive because he just posted on his Instagram. So take us through what he wrote in that post, man.
In this new post, you guys could follow a link, and to that link opens up a landing page. And this landing page reads, I spend most of my days with fleeting thoughts, writing, listening, and collecting old beach cruisers. The morning riots keep me on a hill of silence. I go months without a phone. Love, loss, and grief have disturbed my comfort zone. But the glimmers of God speak through my music and family. While the world around me evolves, I reflect on what matters the most, the life in which my words will land next. As I produce my final TDE album, I feel joy to have been a part of such a cultural imprint after 17 years, the struggles, the success, and most importantly, the brotherhood. May the Most High continue to use Top Dog as a vessel for candid creators as I continue to pursue my life's calling. There's beauty in completion and always faith in the unknown. Thank you all for keeping me in your thoughts. I've prayed for you all. See you soon, Oklahoma. So this is fucking wild, guys. And listen, we're going to keep you updated throughout this whole Kendrick rollout. We don't have a name for the album yet, but he has basically confirmed that he's leaving TDE with one last album. So what are your thoughts on this whole message, man?
I'm fucking hyped. And the main thing that I'm thinking about right now is that with people like Drake and Kanye, you know, supposedly coming soon, nobody is safe. When Kendrick is dropping an album, you know that you're getting probably one of the best of the entire decade, and this is gonna set the bar so fucking high at the start of the 2020s, and we have no idea in which direction he's going. We've heard that it might be a rock influence album from 2020, but now there's so much time that has passed and the pressure is on because he's ending a legacy that he's built with TDE for so many years, where he's given us masterpiece after masterpiece. And I'm just too excited for this, man.
I'm super excited, and it's cool because now he releases this final album and he says that he's going to be leaving TDE. So he's been with them for 17 years, and under TDE's record label, he has released classics such as GKMC, To Pimp a Butterfly, Damn, Section 80, and his run has been perfect over the past decade because Kendrick only puts out flawless material, and I don't expect anything less out of this drop. So what else did you get out of this message? Because there's also rumblings about, you know, him coming back. He says, you know, I'll see you all soon. So that does mean that he is coming with the album. He's also talking about how, you know, he's in a different mindset right now. Like, you know, he's taking his time. He's going months without a phone, gaining perspective. So is this a Kendrick you want to hear on
of
this
course,
next album?
Man. And this is like, this is the start of the rollout. You know, he named this New Thoughts, and people should start getting excited because Kendrick, if you look back at a rollout like Damn in 2017, he had released The Heart Part 4 on March 23rd, 2017, and then he released Damn on April 14th, 2017. So only 22 days passed before the initial announcement and the release of the album, so about 3 weeks. So this could truly be on the horizon, but what's crazy too is that he's saying that he's leaving TDE after, you know, last year there was the whole kind of controversy about him putting out the video where he said that he wasn't leaving TDE and that it was part of his roots and that he never would do that. So what are your thoughts on kind of this exit and where he's going next musically?
I have no idea on like the background information of the exit, but what I do know is that I feel as if Kendrick is going to really go hard on PG Lang and he's going to be able to put
this... Is that a new label, maybe?
Because that's the thing is, like, you know, he opened up with that with Dave Free, and like, that's where the whole discussion had started, was like, okay, what's going on? You know, people were waiting for an album, and instead you had gotten the announcement that he was going to be creating this creative collective sort of brand around certain artists, and you know the affiliates were Georgia Smith, Baby Keem, and other artists. So I think maybe he's going into that direction and he really wants to flourish as a mogul and really spread different words with different artists. But at the moment, it seems like we are getting this last, you know, this final dance. Like,
could
you know,
this be his last album ever, though? Could this be a retirement album? Because it sounds like creatively maybe he wants to go into other ventures. So is that a possibility?
I don't know, but it would be so cool to hear him produce an album without TDE's help or under the label. Like, I feel as if maybe you'd get a different Kendrick, but then again, there's always this question that, you know, Kendrick comes with quality regardless. The only thing that differentiates a Kendrick album from another one is the styles, it's the production, it's the tempo, it's the setting, the messages. So I'm just interested in the new material and I want to see how it evolves after this next album. So let me ask you another question. Do you think this is the possibility that Kendrick actually drops maybe the best album of his career to end off the run?
100%. I mean, he's, you know, only leveled up his game with every release. And I'm not saying that Damn is my favorite Kendrick Lamar album, but there were a lot of, you you know, amazing kind of biblical imagery and passages throughout that project that were kind of subtly mixed in. And he's saying here how God speaks through his music. So that spiritual Kendrick is something we can expect to see here. And he's just going to, he's going to come and he's going to change the whole game, probably innovate with a new style. And at this point, I really want to know how long it's going to fucking take, man, because I can't wait to hear this.
Yeah, and guys, listen, if you guys are hyped for this new Kendrick album as much as we are, you know, just leave it in the comment section. You know, what are your expectations for this next Kendrick album? And smash the like button because it's Kendrick season and we're going to be going through it. But just going on one little subtle point that I had noticed, do you see the way he signs off that letter? Oklama, I believe, if I haven't pronounced it right. And if you look at the domain name, it's the same thing. So maybe our theory of the alter ego will come into play next album. And would you like to see that once again?
I'd love to see the alter ego because Kendrick's brilliantly dived into the shoes of other people on songs like Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst. He's done that on How Much a Dollar Cost. And for him to do a whole concept album where he's diving into somebody else's shoes is a big possibility because if you remember back in September of 2020, he was actually shooting this music video where he was kind of wearing these worn down clothes, sitting on a box with a payphone. So that might have been the beginning of the introduction to this new character that he's bringing. But we'll probably talk more about that when we do what to expect on this new album, which is a video you guys can expect pretty soon. But apart from that, to me, what's cool is that he said that there should be, hold on, let me go back to this point here. Always faith in the unknown. So that means that he knows that we can expect something new from him every time. And now this confirms to me that we're getting something totally different than he's ever done before. But he does end off that letter by saying, see you soon enough. So based on previous Kendrick rollouts, based on how you're feeling right now, man, when do you really think this is coming out?
I don't know because it's a complicated time in hip hop. There's a lot of guys on hold. You know, Donda's supposed to be dropping. CLB's on ice right now.
I don't think Kendrick gives a fuck about that.
And I don't think Kendrick gives a fuck about that because as you saw in previous years, More Life drops, Damn comes right after. And
he loves the competition.
He doesn't care. He never cares.
Take it back to Control, man. The Control verse where he's, you know, going off about, you know, saying how he's the king of New York and king of the West Coast. One hand, I juggle them both. He's always had that competitive spirit in him, and it's not going away anytime soon.
I don't think it is. I really don't think it is. And based on the way that he's already introduced himself with this rollout, it just seems like there's this calm nature to him about, like, I'm not worried about all the background noise, guys. I'm back. I'm going to drop my shit, and you guys are going to fuck with it regardless. So, listen, guys, again, if you are interested in Kendrick Lamar content...
One more thing, though, I want to mention before we end off.
What do you got to say?
Is that there was word that he was be performing at the Day in Vegas Festival this year in November, specifically Friday, November 12th. He's supposed to be performing at the Day in Vegas Festival in Las Vegas. And what's interesting is that if you look at the poster lineup, it says that Kendrick Lamar will be performing songs from Section 80 to Damn, meaning that it seems like the album or new music won't be available until after November. But maybe that was kind of put there to kind of mislead us and to kind of now give us the surprise of new music before the festival. So do you think he'll drop before or after that festival of Day in
Vegas?
That's
a good question. Thank God we ended off with this question.
I think he's dropping before, man.
I think he's dropping before.
If you look at the Damn rollout, like I said, only 3 weeks passed. If you look at T-Pab, he did drop two singles, and he dropped the album 6 months after dropping I and Black or the Berry. So he could maybe do the singles first and then drop the album, but I don't think that's in Kendrick's nature anymore. I think he's dropping in a few weeks.
And guys, listen, it's such a hype time to be a Kendrick fan. We have been waiting for nearly almost 5 years now, and it's getting pretty crazy. You know, the industry is eating up, and as you guys know, NFR is covering all of this content. We will take you through every step of this new Kendrick Lamar rollout. So all of the updates that's come, the review and the reaction, and all of the post rollout with everything that you guys could find in the album. So thank you so much for watching this. Make sure you're subscribed, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thank you for watching the video. It's always a pleasure doing content for you guys. Listen, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel because we're doing album reviews and we actually have our series called Everything We Know where we take you guys through the whole album rollout of the hottest releases of the year. Not only that, guys, but our Patreon plan is now live. You guys could access that in the bio. I appreciate you guys and I'll see you on the next one.